Hello, YouTubes. I hope you enjoy my show today. Today, the set announcements of the Grand Creator. It's the next 60 core card set. Yep, the next sort of build your decks deck. So we have got 60 cards in this set. Yep, 10 of them are ultra rares, 15 are supers, 35 are rare. Yep, and 15 are collectible rares. This set is very good because of the Venture Token stuff. Yes, that's what the deck's gonna be called. Yes, not the greatest name. I would have gone with a better name than that, but hey ho. I actually would have kept Brave because Brave actually was pretty good. Yep, I think this set will be very good. There's two art types will be very good and one sort of. We'll talk about them in a bit. We got the new Punk art type. Yes, so Punk are basically all psychic base, hence the name Punk and psychic, yep. And they're all basically, you have to pay, all the lower monsters have to pay 600 life points, yep, basically. Yep, and then you discard one card, and then you discard one card from your, and the high monsters, oh, we're missing one. Oh, we need to edit that then. Home for. Yeah, Mr. Fox one. If it learns to listen, Mr. Smart Computer would have pressed it already. Come on, Mr. Smart. Oh, it's. I think it's ready there. Okay. Yeah, bye. There it is there. Yeah, it's much better. Oh, we went too fast now. Right, so where were we? Oh yeah, Punk. So Punk is basically a psychic based deck when you pay 600 for everything. So you've got this card here searches a monster. This card here searches a spec. Oh great. Can you have Mr. Smart, please? So this one searches spells, this one you have to pay 600 to summon a fusion or a synchron on an opponent's turn, which is kind of cool. Then you got a rotor supposed to be here, so this one's level 8, and basically this one can search can summon a punk monster from your deck, which is really cool. This one you can just discard this card in itself to add one or special summon one from your hand, so that's pretty cool. The fusion special summons two from the deck, which is really nice. Then you got the synchron, basically it's like a bounce depending how many tails you use for this card, which is really cool. Then you got two spells, basically they destroy, they can't destroy with card effects, so it's pointless playing those. Then you got the new trap card. This one's really good. This one's sort of like an impermanence, but if you got a punk on the field, you gain so many life points, which is good because you're paying a lot of life points in this deck. And then this one's like a walking book of moon. It's like a book of moon or a trident in a trap card. Basically, it destroys one card face up. If you got a punk face up, if you've not got a punk, it does sort of a book of moon effect, which is kind of cool. So at the moment, I don't think it would do very much, but sort of future deck. I think in post sort of Dimension Force, I think this deck will be good. I think this deck will have some potential. Yep. And that's the other card anyway I was talking about. And next is the Exosisters. Exosisters are quite weirdly. So when you control an Exosister card, basically, if the opponent moves one monster, hold on, let me read this correctly. If the opponent move one monster. That summons one monster from the graveyard. Move one card from the graveyard for the. You can summon one XD monster from your extra deck. Yep. So basically, the opponent needs to move a certain card from the graveyard to summon their XE monsters. So it's kind of worded weirdly. They're all level 4, they're all spellcasters, and the XDs are warrior based. So they're okay. They're just a good rank 4 spam deck, heck, which is a cool thing. The deck's not amazing. They're all puny, which is not great. So if players are smart, they'll just attack them, and then that's them deal with. That's what's not sort of good about them. But they're very good and very, they're alright. They're not doing very much in OCG, so. Yeah, the spells are pretty good. There's one special summon, there's one of the traps is really good, like special summons one from the deck and stuff like that, which is cool. Pretty handy, this deck. It needs to do a lot more. There's another XD coming in Generation Force, which doesn't do very much, this deck, so I haven't seen it yet pop on OCG. Maybe it's hard for them to get, so it's not always a good thing. So I don't think this deck has much potential. And then we got the Brave stuff. So Brave tokens or Adventure tokens now it's called. They're basically this little engine. You got this card here, the Rise of Anison, of Alephar. So basically this card, discard one card from your hand. Discard this, advance this card from your hand, or the grey, and you basically search out this. You search Rise of Anison, of Alephar. Then Rise of Alephar will get you the continuous spell card. Then the continuous spell card can get you one of these cards over here. So it can get you equipped, which you will need to play for. We need to play one of each of these, or one of them. So then you've got the negate here. This is your negate, basically. And then this card here is like another monster you can play, but not many people play it. Then you got the field spell, which is not very good. You got two field spell, which is really weird. And then you got the two traps. It's just a nice little engine index. It basically gives you another form of negate actually, and you can search, which is really busted. This deck is based, this engine is everywhere in the ocean, and it probably will be here. It's a shame we're not getting this week, because it would have been quite cool to see in the YCS Europe. Yeah. Yeah. It's a shame, but hey ho. I think this deck will be excellent once it comes out, and it'll be as a nice little engine. You can't play as a deck, but it's a nice little engine, which is good, which is cool. Then we got our reprints. Yep. This is our reprints. Hints and the new TCG card. So the new TCG card is for Inceptor. So this card is called Setsan Sukuko. Okay, this card always is treated as an Inceptor card. Basically, send one other Inceptor card from your deck, from your hand, or face up on the field to activate one of four effects. You can select to special summon one Inceptor from your deck. Or to equip one Inceptor as a quick spell from to an insect monster you control. Gary, break this card, fit monster. This fixes all the problems Inceptors had, and insect decks in general. First thing first up, does not mean you need normal zone in Inceptors. Yep. It always gives you a quip, which is excellent. You can quip straight from the deck, which is absolutely excellent. It fixes all those problems. You must play this free, because this is like emergency teleport for this deck. Okay, other reprints up are all the Inceptor stuff. So all the good Inceptors are reprinted in here. Yep, so we've got Dragonfly, Hornet, Centipede, Hopper, and Ladybug, which is good, which is cool. And then we have got the other Brave stuff, obviously the Brave stuff to talk about. And then the other Extra Sister cards here, which is cool, which is not reprint. Then the other reprints are Anbol, the Star Alpha. Then we got Goki Paul, Psychic Wheeler, Psychic Taker, Birchwell, Shin, the other Inceptors, yep. Castell, Inceptor, Piccolina, Insect. ever in incantation. Tight brethren, that's for the exorcists, I think. Oh shoot. And we post, and we have obviously armory, matched airport, Inceptor Caliber, which is good, and then trial shift, your exorcist, Star Strike and Armor, and there's the two Newtopia casts. In Newtopia, so Zeus is a reprint in the sets, which you haven't got a picture on, unfortunately, and Draco Future Dragon is another reprint. You will see is in this set also, which is absolutely excellent. Makes those cards much cheaper. Zeus is good because it makes it cheaper, about under 10 now. And Draco will make that now, that'll be about 15, so that will go down by half, which is absolutely excellent. It means I could afford that card and play in other decks which I wanted to play it in anyway, because it was really annoying to have to try and pull that card and really hard, because it is 30 quid and it's one of those cards that stops me playing the Lair of Luz Tribe Brigade deck, which is a shame because it's a really fun deck and I really like that deck. Yeah. I think this is going to be a very good set. It comes out next week. Comes out next Friday. Yep, on the 28th. Hey, which is cool, which is good. Right, I hope you're drawing. We're about to show you today. Subscribe from what show? Good luck for the YCS. Is anyone competing in YCS Europe this weekend? Yep. Wish me happy birthday for Wednesday. Even though you will see me before Wednesday. I hope you're drawing. Well, show you today. Good luck, everyone, at the YCS. And... peace, everyone. Good luck at doing, everyone, especially the YCS.